It's time for the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show with Wiley Pirate head football coach, Jimmy Carter. Joining Coach Carter is Pirate host, Derek Draper.
Welcome to the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show with Wiley Pirate head football coach, Jimmy Carter. And I'm Derek Draper, Coach Carter. Congrats on Friday. And he said it wasn't before. Play scoring drive, they went 81 yards, and the Pirates' first possession ended with a turnover, and it seemed like the momentum was all Naaman Forrest. Did that seem? I don't know if that to you guys on the coaching
kind of opposite
of
what we want, right? We want to score on offense,
right?
Three and out or a turnover. I was really happy though that our kids, didn't go in the tank and kind of get shell shocked. They come back and they fought, and end up going, up 24-7.
Yeah, and the defense really came out after that, and did not. Naaman Forrest didn't score until like 4 minutes left in the third quarter, and the Pirates got a big turnover off kickoffs for the second week in a row. And I know special teams. We'll talk about the ending, but special teams played a big role, I think, this week. And especially the kickoff. And what are you trying to do with the kickoffs?
Spencer and going back to his brother Braden and the Cunninghams and Nally. We've been fortunate for about the last 10 or 12 years to be able to have our kickers be able to kick it kind of where we want them to, and be directional with it and intentional, with the giving a same look. And our kids know where we're going to go with it. And so Spencer's done a really good job with that, the last couple of weeks. And so, we were able to I won't say find a weakness, but find a hole in the kickoff return game. And then, we try to take advantage of that. And Coach Washington, I think I've said before, him coming in and just giving a new attitude to our special teams has been awesome.
And Pirates took a 17-7 lead in halftime. What did you tell your players at halftime?
We just got to keep fighting. We can talk about it here in a minute too, but our big pregame speech, the Thursday night meeting was, we talked about 1 inch, and how the game of football, the cliche is a game of inches, but literally there was an inch somewhere out there and everybody had to go find that inch the other night.
Yeah, and the Pirates scored on their second possession of the first second half. It seemed like at that point the Pirates were pretty much in control, and then Naaman Forrest had some successful drives. And were they doing anything differently offensively at that point, or how did they find success?
Yeah, I don't know. After we went up 24-7, then we were driving and could have made it 31-7. Had an untimely penalty there around midfield and just couldn't overcome that penalty. And then it just seemed like the momentum, switched when we had to punt there. And, Naaman did a good job. Like I said, the Perales kid at quarterback is just, good. The Deal kid at receiver, they've got good skill kids. They made some plays, and we weren't, we were just an inch short, right through there. So, gave them some momentum coming back.
Well, the Pirates had a 3-point lead with 3:03 on the clock. Defense went down there, held them, and then they got interesting after them. They got the ball back. The Rangers got the ball back with 2:35 left on the clock and only 47 yards to go to score. The defense did hold them to a field goal, tied the game with 22 seconds left. What was going on in your mind at that point in time?
To be honest with you, I'd already started, going through overtime scenarios, and talking with Coach Doty in the headsets and Coach Shields, about overtime scenarios. But, when you look at the sequence of events there, I'm not sure exactly what the Naaman Forrest kid did after the field goal to get the unsportsmanlike or the personal foul. But, that gave us a 15-yard bump right there. And then Dalen Gordon had a good return.
Yeah.
And then we get another 15-yard bump up. Then we throw an out route to Mitchell George. He couldn't get out of bounds, so I had to use our last time out. And then had a play called, and Naaman called a timeout, which we're glad that they did because we didn't like the play we had called. And so we were able to change the play and was able to, you know, to throw an out to Alejandro Morales there, you know, to have time to kick a field goal.
Two big catches at the end, clutch plays, and then what happened on those two field goals? You got two chances.
So 42-yard field goal to start with. Spence, you know, hit the ball good, just pushed it out right. He said he felt like he could feel that kid coming, and he kind of, you know, was scared to plant it completely. He got roughed, so that was a 15-yarder. And so I was all happy and everything, and come to find out he had gotten a unsportsmanlike penalty on himself because he got mad after the guy hit him in the leg, and he went and pushed the guy. So, you know, which we don't condone that, but it is what it is. We actually ended up coming out on the short end of that stick. So we went half the distance to the goal on the roughing kicker, back 15 on the unsportsmanlike. So it ended up being a 44-yard field goal. The snap wasn't as good. It was a little behind Cooper a little bit. Cooper did a great job of getting it down. And then Spence didn't quite hit it as good. And it didn't look good to me. But Coach Bogle was standing beside me and goes, "Oh, it's good." And literally it came down to that inch we talked about, you know.
From our advantage point, from the vantage point from the press box, it did not look good. And it didn't look good. All we saw were the back judges giving the field goal signal. Oh. So pretty incredible. I mean, that was an incredible turn of events.
It was fun, and a lot of it, you know, was self-inflicted, you know, stuff, adversity that, you know, learning from it too, as, you know, moving forward.
And what did you tell your players after the game?
I was just happy the way they, you know, stuck in there. You know, a lot of people would, you know, unless you're in the NFL with 22 seconds, usually the game's over. Mm-hmm. You're going to take a knee and go to overtime. But, you know, as an offensive staff, you know, and they felt like that we had a good shot, especially where we're at on the field. And, you know, and our kids did a great job because they told me that the last play that Alejandro caught, that it's not a play that we practice every week. It's one that we have practiced months ago, and the kids just remembered it and ran it correctly.
Mm-hmm. So what did you like from your offense on Friday?
Early I liked the way they were getting after the ball. You know, second half we kind of shot ourselves in the foot a few times. We still haven't put that complete, you know, game together.
Mm-hmm. And it looked like the offensive line was having good success, especially in that first half.
Yeah.
And I know you were down a player, a starter, but it did look like they did a good job containing those front six.
Yeah, they did a good job. You know, and like I said, Naaman's got one of the best front sixes, you know, that we've seen or will see this year. You know, they're really good. The Vincent kid is a really good linebacker. But I thought our kids did really well. They gave Jagger time, and we ended up rushing for like 178 yards.
Who were some standouts on the offensive side of the ball?
Our whole offensive line, you know, but, you know, Michael Oyeka, first and foremost, you know, the vocal leader of that group, you know, just gets after it. You know, Jagger did another good job. Mm-hmm. Josh Osborne did good. You know, you got to brag on Alejandro Morales, you know. Hadn't played a whole lot, but, you know, had a big catch there at the end of the game.
Yeah, that's great. And defensively, what were some positive aspects?
You know, defensively, we didn't give up. You know, you give them the ball back, and they got all the momentum right there with, you know, just a minute or two left in the game. And, you know, we were able to hold and make them kick a field goal. You know, those points were huge. You give up a touchdown there, it's probably a different story, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know, I love the way that they're flying around to the football and just getting after it.
So who stood out defensively on
Friday? Harrison Bisek again, you know, just having a great game. You know, I think Ryan Waters is doing a great job at safety. You know, we played Martavion Sanders quite a bit at corner this week. You know, he had some good plays there. You know, I thought that Tyler Helton came in at outside linebacker and got after it. You know, just relentless attitude, you know, had a couple sacks.
So. Yeah, well played at the outside linebacker position. Well, thank you for joining us for the first half of the Dickey's Barbecue Coach Show. Here is a word from Dickey's.
Since 1941, Dickey's Barbecue Pit has been smoking the very best quality meats for 14 hours every day. It's how Mr. Dickey did it, and it's how we still do it in every Dickey's restaurant across America. Come in and see us or visit Dickey's.com.
Welcome back to the Dickey's Barbecue Coach's Show with Wiley Pirate head football coach Jimmy Carter. And Coach, this week is Thursday night. Thursday Night Lights here, and not on Amazon Prime, but at Wiley Stadium. and the Pirates take on the Rowlett Eagles. They come to town. Head coach Derek Alford, they're 3-2 on the season, 2-1 in district play. They've got wins against Neyman Forest and against South Garland. They lost to Garland last week, 17-0. What kind of offense do they run?
They're an RPO style offense. You know, they're going to do the run pass reads, you know, get the ball out really quick. They have two quarterback system. Both quarterbacks can throw the ball really well, and they read the run really well. Huge offensive line, so a very fast paced offense once they snap the football.
And as far as other personnel, I mean, they said quarterback's pretty good.
Both quarterbacks. They have two quarterbacks. One's a junior, one's a sophomore. He's got a couple favorite targets, on the outside that he likes to throw the ball to on the quick slants. Huge offensive line, probably one of the biggest centers that we've faced all year long. So Brady will have a tough go there with a big man Friday night.
Defensively, what kind of defense do they run? Who are some of their personnel?
Defensively, they give us two different looks. They give us a four-man front and a three-man front. Same personnel on the field. They just kind of move a linebacker down and make him a D lineman. When they go to the four-man front, it kind of depends on the down and distance and the formation that you're in. As much as we formation and sub people in and out, it'll be kind of hard to tell what they're going to give us. D-line, they got a couple of returners there in the middle. One, number 91, I believe it is, big kid, really good, returning from last year. Linebacker core can run, they like to hit. The secondary is very solid. They've had some turnovers this year.
Yeah, so what kind of a game do you anticipate?
I think it'll be a smash-mouth game. Of course, we always say we want to establish a running game, and, that's what we're going to try to do is run the football. They're going to try to hit the quick run and the quick pass. So to me, that's another run play, just that quick one or 2 yard pass.
Pirates play this Thursday, October the 10th, here at Pirates Stadium, 7 p.m. How can Pirate fans purchase tickets?
You can go to the Wiley ISD Athletic webpage and go to Hometown Ticketing and purchase your tickets there. Or there'll be a QR code at the gate and you can purchase tickets there.
As far as watching online, I believe Wiley ISD should have a link to the live stream. You can also listen at wildpiratefootball.com. We'll have Coach's pregame interview. We'll have the Dickey's Barbecue Trivia Contest, and we go on air at 6:30. Coach, we're filming this on Monday, tomorrow night. That'd be October the 8th. Tell us what's going on that.
Tomorrow night we got the big Crosstown Showdown volleyball match. It'll be a district championship type atmosphere, here in the Montgomery Center. And, we'd really like to pack that thing out tomorrow night and support our girls playing volleyball. So it'd be a big game.
So come out Tuesday night, October the 8th, and then come out Thursday night, October the 10th, support your Pirates. And that wraps it up for the coaches show and for Wiley Pirate head football coach Jimmy Carter. I'm Derek Draper. Thanks for watching.